hallucinations, which can make it easier to manage emotions. Identifying and labeling emotions. This skill involves being able to accurately identify and name emotions as they arise. Namely, emotions can help individuals to understand and make sense of them, which can make them more manageable. Reframing. This skill involves looking at a situation or thought from a different perspective. Reframing can help to reduce negative thoughts and emotions by changing the way an individual views a situation. Distress tolerance. Involves learning how to tolerate and manage difficult emotions without making them worse. Distress tolerance skills can include things like deep breathing, progressive muscle relaxation, and self-soothing techniques. Involves finding healthy ways to express and communicate emotions to others. Emotion expression can help individuals to feel heard, validated, and understood. Emotion prevention. This skill involves learning how to prevent negative emotions from arising in the first place. Emotion prevention can include activities such as regular exercise, getting enough sleep, and practicing good self-care. Interpersonal effectiveness. This skill involves being able to assert oneself and communicate effectively in person and professional relationships. Interpersonal effectiveness can help individuals to build and maintain healthy relationships and avoid or resolve conflicts. Modulation. This skill involves learning how to change the intensity or duration of an emotion once it has been experienced. These are some examples of the skills that can be used to regulate emotions. And it's important to note that these skills can learned and practiced, and should be tailored to fit the individual's needs. What makes an emotion negative, and why? Cafe selected emotion. Emotion is considered to be negative.